All right, you think you're the grill master? Think you know how to cook because you've got a fancy stove? Let me tell you a shocking secret. The real culinary boss didn't use a gas range or a gourmet BBQ. He used raw, untamed fire from nature. And he didn't just grill a steak, he cooked humanity's future. He was the one who mastered fire, left Africa, and colonized half the planet. Like, seriously, think of a guy who won at life, who became the main player in the game of evolution. But what if I told you that after doing all that, after holding the superpower of fire in his hands, this species simply vanished? How the hell did a revolutionary like that go extinct? What happened to Homo Erectus, the first master of fire and adventure? His story is a plot twist that science is still trying to decipher. Get ready to gain access to the most epic and mysterious stories of human evolution. And if that question has already got you hooked, go ahead and smash that like button and subscribe to Extinct Doc, because we're about to make you question everything you think about success and survival. We'll show you that the strongest or smartest doesn't always win the trophy. You good? Let's do this. To start, we need to talk about the biggest hack in prehistory, the mastery of fire. For a long time, it was thought that various hominins occasionally used fire, like picking up a branch from a lightning-struck tree. But Homo Erectus was the first to say, "All right, this power is mine, and I'm going to use it to change the game." The oldest and most undeniable evidence of controlled fire comes from archaeological sites like Wunderwerk Cave in South Africa. There, archaeologists like Francesco Berna of Boston University found remains of burned bones and microscopic ash dated to an impressive 1 million years ago. Other evidence, like that from Gesher Ben Yaakov Bridge in Israel, studied by Dr. Nama Goren Imbar, shows continuous and deliberate use of fire 790,000 years ago, with remains of cooked seeds and fish. Homo Erectus wasn't just a casual user, he was the master of fire. He knew how to start it, how to keep it going, and how to use this force of nature strategically. And fire wasn't just a little bonfire for roasting prehistoric marshmallows. It was the real upgrade that changed everything in the game of life. Superheater and security. On cold, freezing nights, common during the glacial periods of the Pleistocene, fire kept the clan warm, preventing hypothermia, and, more importantly, it kept dangerous predators away. A lion, a saber-toothed tiger, or a giant hyena wouldn't dare approach the glow and warmth of an open fire. It was our invisible shield, a barrier that gave us security. Light in the darkness. Primitive nights were pitch black, full of dangers and invisibility. Fire provided essential light for complex tasks after sunset, like making and repairing tools, processing food, socializing, and, crucially, extending the day of work or social interaction. This boosted our productivity and social bonding time. It was the recipe for intelligence, a true power plant for our minds. Fire wasn't just a luxury, it was the technology that pulled us out of the Dark Ages and put us on the path to dominate the planet. Homo Erectus didn't just discover fire, he domesticated it and used it to transform himself, to reinvent himself. Armed with the superpower of fire and a brain supercharged by the new diet, Homo Erectus did what no other hominin had ever done before. He left Africa. It wasn't a walk in the park. It was the first great human odyssey, a migration that changed the course of the planet and proved the resilience of our lineage. Nearly 1.8 million years ago, they began to spread. Evidence from Demonesy, Georgia, a crucial archaeological site, shows they were already in Europe 1.8 million years ago, with fossils of Homo Erectus georgicus, challenging the idea that the Out of Africa event was a single occurrence. They arrived there with bodies already adapted for long-distance travel. The famous Turkana boy skeleton, Homo erectus KNM-15000 from Kenya, dated by researchers like Richard Leakey to 1.5 million years ago, shows a youth who as an adult would have stood over 5'11", 1.8 meters tall, with long legs and body proportions similar to ours. He was a walking, exploring machine. They didn't have maps, GPS, or running shoes, but they had fire, social cooperation, and the ability to adapt to completely new environments, from deserts to temperate climates. They spread across Asia, reaching as far as China, with famous fossils from Zhukaojun near Beijing, dated to hundreds of thousands of years ago, and Indonesia, in Java, they found Java Man, or Pithecanthropus erectus. They also ventured into Europe, with sites like Ciprano, Italy, facing harsh winters and new faunas. Homo erectus was the first true global player of humanity. He proved that our lineage was no longer confined to a single continent. He didn't just survive, he colonized, he explored, he left his marks across more than half the known world at the time. An absurd and unprecedented feat for such an ancient species, one that deserves all our respect. Mastering fire or leaving Africa? Which of these two feats by Homo erectus do you think was the most revolutionary for the future of humanity? Tell me your opinion in the comments.
But Homo erectus wasn't just a wanderer with fire. He was a Stone Age engineer, a master of technology who transformed how we interacted with the world. His tools weren't just rocks, they were projects with sophisticated design. He brought with him the Acheulean industry, a massive technological leap compared to the simpler Aldoan tools of Homo habilis. The flagship product? The bifacial hand axe. A teardrop-shaped tool flaked carefully on both sides with perfect symmetry and an edge as sharp as a knife. This hand axe wasn't just a potent weapon, it was a prehistoric Swiss Army knife, a definitive multi-purpose tool. It served to cut meat, scrape hides, chop wood, dig for roots, and even as a projectile in a hunt. And they were incredibly efficient. At sites like Boxgrove in England, archaeologists found hand axe manufacturing workshops where erectus could produce hundreds of these tools with incredible efficiency, showing a large-scale production process and refined technical knowledge. They weren't just hunters, they were manufacturers with tool production lines. With these top-tier tools, Homo erectus became a more efficient and versatile hunter. He hunted medium and large animals, like deer, bison, and even megafauna. He used intelligence to coordinate groups, to track, and to ambush prey. The proof comes from sites like Schöningen in Germany, where wooden spears over 300,000 years old were found, perfectly balanced for throwing, showing that erectus was already an active and sophisticated hunter, not just an opportunistic scavenger. He was the first great long-range predator, using his mind and his weapons to control the environment. And social cooperation? It was vital. In these groups that traveled and hunted across vast territories, collaboration was the key to survival. Sharing knowledge about tools, hunting tactics, the location of resources, water, seasonal foods, and clan safety was what kept the species alive and thriving in such challenging environments, from the African savannas to the icy valleys of Europe. After mastering fire, conquering continents, and creating incredible technologies, Homo erectus reigned for nearly 1.5 million years. He is one of the most successful and resilient human species in history, a true rock star of evolution. But around 300,000 to 100,000 years ago, this extraordinary lineage began to disappear, gradually being replaced by newer species like Homo heidelbergensis, who gave rise to Neanderthals and us, Homo sapiens. What happened to the forgotten revolutionary? Why did he vanish? It's one of the great mysteries of paleoanthropology, and there are several theories, each with its own proponents and evidence. Extreme climate change. During the Pleistocene, Earth's climate continued to oscillate violently and unpredictably. Long interglacial periods, warmer, were followed by brutal and rapid glaciations. Homo erectus was a master of adaptation, but the fluctuations were so drastic and rapid that perhaps his capacity to adapt biologically and technologically was simply overwhelmed by the changes. They were good, but the planet became hardcore beyond their limits. Competition with newer, smarter species. As Homo erectus spread, he encountered and was encountered by newer hominin species like Homo heidelbergensis in Europe and Africa, and later Neanderthals and us, Homo sapiens. These newer species might have had more efficient tools like microliths, more efficient hunting strategies like the otlot or persistent hunting, and more efficient social organization outcompeting erectus for resources and territory. Evolution doesn't accept a tie. The evolutionary laziness theory. Some researchers like Dr. Siri Shipton of the Australian National University propose a more controversial theory. Homo erectus was somewhat lazy or less inventive. They used the same Oculean tools for millions of years without much innovation. They seemed to have an aversion to leaving their comfort zone and exploring new technologies or distant raw materials. This lack of constant innovation and cultural flexibility in a world that was rapidly changing may have been his Achilles heel, a fatal software update failure. Fusion or assimilation and genetic dilution. Another possibility is that they didn't completely disappear, but were assimilated by the newer lineages. As newer Homo species spread and encountered Homo erectus populations, interbreeding may have occurred. This interbreeding diluted the Homo erectus DNA over generations until his identity as a separate species was lost in the gene pool of the descendant species. They became part of the new. The truth is, it was likely a combination of factors. Homo erectus was a titan of evolution, a true trailblazer. But life in prehistory is unforgiving. Even the greatest pioneers can be surpassed by time and evolution, or simply absorbed by the next big thing. Homo erectus was a titan, but he vanished. In your opinion, which factor was the most decisive for the end of this incredible species? The unrelenting climate? Competition with newer, smarter species? Or a possible laziness in innovation? Drop your thoughts in the comments. Homo erectus was the true revolutionary, the master of fire, the first global explorer, the Stone Age engineer. He paved the way for us, Homo sapiens, and gave us the legacy that we are capable of mastering any environment. His story is a reminder that evolution is brutal, but human ingenuity is an unbeatable force. And if you want to gain more access to these deleted and epic chapters of our planet's history, you know what to do. Subscribe to Extinct Doc and hit the bell, because every week we uncover a new secret. Leave a like if this trip to the past made you see fire and tools in a totally new way. And share this video with that friend of yours who thinks they invented the wheel. Show them who the real inventors were. Thanks for hanging with us. See you next time.